prayer really helps. It really helps. And how God uses his prayer. I know I covet your prayers. And, you know, what are you going to do except take it to the Lord? Right? Just like Brother Ed and what's her name, Ed? What's her name?
Vicky.
Vicky. They have a son that's worked at a place for 27 years. And they just let him go. So, you know, things like that are heavy on your heart and mind. And it's hard to take. And, you know, how can you understand things like that? You just have to put it in God's name and keep on moving. But that's what prayer is all about. I don't know how people make it without prayer. I really don't. Only the Lord. I have a message here. I'm going to put it in my back pocket. And we're just going to concentrate on the Lord's Supper tonight. Apostle made a statement as we came in. And he said, I don't know if we really realize the importance of this. This all focuses on Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And what Jesus did for us. That's what this is all about. To remember his death, burial, and resurrection until he comes back, and then we're going to celebrate with him. Amen.
Amen.
But until that time, it's our responsibility to have this. In 1 Corinthians chapter 11, Paul says, I have received of the Lord that which I delivered unto you. The order and meaning of the Lord's Supper, Paul said, God told me, I'm telling you, that Jesus Christ, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, take ye, this is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. So, after we read that verse, we pray and ask God to, and give thanks to God for his broken body. I preached a message one time on the large body of Jesus. The Bible teaches us that he was so marred that you couldn't tell who he was. I mean, we have this picture of, you know, somebody on the TV or movie or whatever, long hair, just trotting along, you know. It's unbelievable what he suffered that day for us. And so, when we read the scripture and we get ready to partake of that bread, we remember his broken body and thank him. That's why we pray and give thanks. And after the same manner, he took the cup, and when he had supped, saying, this cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as oft as ye drink it in remembrance of me. We read the scripture verse about taking the cup. Then we give it out, or we pray, and we thank the Lord for the blood that he shed for us that day. I mean, every drop of blood in his body drained out that day. He gave it all. For as often as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do show the Lord's death until he comes. That's the purpose of it. His death, his burial, and his resurrection. But it says, whosoever shall eat this bread, drink this cup of the Lord unworthily, shall be guilty of the body and blood of the Lord. What is he talking about? He's talking about when we partake of the Lord's Supper, we better know what we're doing. Amen. And that's what it's all about. This, the Catholics teach that when you partake of the bread and Jews that you're actually partaking of Jesus' body. That's not what Jesus wants you to do. And that's not your salvation. Your salvation is in a person, Jesus himself.
Amen.
And he wants us to remember his broken body and remember his shed blood until he comes back again. So the whole focus on the Lord's Supper is on Jesus. It's not on me. The only benefit I get out of it is obeying the Word of God and just doing what Jesus tells me to do until he comes back again. But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup. he that eateth and drinketh unworthily eateth and drinketh damnation or judgment to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. In other words, if we partake of the Lord's Supper for any other reason other than to remember the blood and broken body of Jesus, then it's not right. For this caused many a weak and sickly among you, many sleep. For if we would judge ourselves, we should not be judged. But when we are judged, we are chastened of the Lord, that we should not be condemned with the world. Wherefore, my brother, when you come together to eat, tarry one for another. If any man hunger, let him eat at home, that ye come not together under condemnation, and the rest will I set in order when I come. So these people were using the Lord's Supper as a drunken orgy. The people that were rich would come and bring their wine and get drunk and eat and vomit and eat some more and all that kind of stuff. And the poor people just didn't have anything to eat. And Paul told them that, you know, this is wrong and you're going to be judged for it. But in Matthew chapter 26, that's where we always go when we partake of the Lord's Supper. Does anybody have a testimony or a thought concerning the Lord's Supper, what it means to you? Yes, Jeff.